Well, hello, everyone. It's Don Baine, the Gadget Professor, coming to you live from our Scottsdale, Arizona studio. It is February 19th, 2015. I have an amazing Bluetooth speaker that I know you've never seen it before because I saw it at CES, and the people from BenQ have flown in from Texas today right here in the studio to show it to you live.
He's got the toys. He's got showmanship. And he's got sex appeal. Ladies and gentlemen, from the great Southwest, here's the guru of gadgets, the dapper and dashing Don Baine, the Gadget Professor.
Gadget Professor.
Well, hello, everyone. It's Don Baine, the Gadget Professor, coming to you live from our Scottsdale, Arizona studio. It is February 19th, getting close to the Gadget Professor's birthday, but I'm not going to tell anybody when it is. You'll have to guess. We have a phenomenal show today. We actually have the people from BenQ sitting right here, and they're going to show you a very cool, brand-new device. It's a Bluetooth electrostatic speaker, and the sound is quite impressive, so you'll want to stay tuned to hear that interview coming up shortly. These guys flew in all the way from Texas, and I want to get them on the air as soon as we can. I'm pleased to announce that today's show is brought to you by Data Video. Data Video has the most amazing product line and depth that I've ever seen of any company out there in the digital video space. So you want to definitely dial into datavideo.com and check out their product line. They have all kinds of phenomenal converters that will go up against anybody. Believe me, they have phenomenal video production equipment and slow-mo drives, all kinds of really cool things. So definitely check datavideo.com out, and you'll hear more about that in the coming up episodes of The Gadget Professor. Well, as you know, everyone, we were on episode 195. We had a cool show last week on the WD 2TB My Passport wireless drive, and I'm loving that. I'm using that almost every day, and it works quite well, and we're really pleased with that. If you're brand new and just tuning in for the first time to The Gadget Professor, thank you so much for tuning in. There's a lot of ways that you can watch The Gadget Professor. We're now watched in 172 countries around the world. To make it real easy, just go to thegadgetprofessor.com. Our website will have all our episodes on there. Also, what you want to do, folks, really is go over to the right-hand page, and you'll see the button that says newsletter. And right there, just put in your email address, and essentially what will happen is every Thursday evening before the show is actually posted, you will get a notice that it's up and ready to roll, and you will watch it. Also, you can check us out on iTunes. We are on Twitter. We are on Facebook. Facebook is Facebook.com/TheGadgetProfessor. I got all kinds of photos and new interesting information coming up daily on that. You can also ask me a question. You can actually email me at thegadgetprofessor@gmail.com. That would be thegadgetprofessor@gmail.com. If you want to follow us on Twitter, that's easy to do. It's @gadgetprofessor. And last but not least, check it out, rebelmouse.com/gadgetprofessor page. That is a cool page because every single gadget that's new or cool shows up dynamically, instantaneously on this page. And this page will change 20, 30 times a day, and you can just look at a gadget that appeals to you, click on it, and you get all the information. So check all that out, and we're very happy to have you on board. Well, in the news today, everybody is watching for the Apple Watch, and it's going to be, they say, the most successful smartwatch ever. And Apple Watch will play a major role in the wearable market this year and beyond, according to the research company firm CCS. The worldwide wearable sales spike in 2015 jumped 158% over the year to 75 million units. That's a lot of units. And now they feel when the Apple Watch comes out very soon, they will sell up to 20 million units alone. Just that's what they're predicting of just the Apple Watch. So it's coming out at a price, we think, around $350. I have not seen it yet. And they sold, let's see here, Piper analyst Gene Munster in December predicted sales of 8 million for 2015. Now they're predicting 20 million in sales. So We shall see what happens. If you want to check out the feature set, CNET did a nice job. They put up the actual initial presentation of the iWatch that shows all the features and actually the whole speech. And it looks pretty cool. And, of course, the Gadget Professor will be foaming at the mouth to get one of those. Usually I like to wait till the first rev goes by before I buy anything. But, you know, Apple usually hits it right. I'm sure there'll be some bugs that they'll fix. But this watch really looks cool, and there's a lot of people waiting for it. It does just about everything the smartphone does, so it should be pretty cool, and I'll keep you posted on that. Now, here's a great deal that I just stumbled across. Amazon and a company called Slingbox is actually offering this. And right now, for $39, free shipping if you're a Prime member, you will get the Amazon Fire Stick, which is a small USB dongle, if you will. And additionally, for the $39, you're going to get a free stick and 3 months free of Sling TV. And Sling TV supposedly said that this is the device you'll use, this is the vehicle used to cut the cord. So Sling TV is pretty cool. And if you're wondering what it looks like and what you get sports. You can add different features for $5 a month if you so like. But they have a pretty good lineup of shows to watch. And you can actually go to the sling.com and see all the things that are available. ESPN is available. The shows that you absolutely must see, like Property Brothers, Restaurant Redemption, Rehab Addict, Beat Bobby Flay, American Dad, on and on. So there's a bunch of that. There's a lot of kids programming. Mickey Mouse is on there. I like Mickey Mouse. I used to watch the Mickey Mouse Club when I was a kid. They've got CNN News, HLN, and a lot of other things that are on there. Is it a total replacement for TV, for cable? I don't think so. But if you're on the go and on the move and want a combination of news, sports, and some family programming, this just might be the solution for you. And again, for $39, you're going to get 3 months free of Sling TV plus the Fire Stick. It's not a bad deal at all, so you might want to check that out. And right now, folks, it's my pleasure. We are going to take a look at the gadget of the day, and I'm going to introduce you to the wonderful person at BenQ. So let's check this out. Well, folks, here's the moment you've been waiting for, the gadget of the day, and I have Mr. Bob Wudick here from a company called BenQ, and he is the associate VP at BenQ, and he has flown in this morning all the way from Texas to show us this, just what I think is the best Bluetooth speaker. I'm gonna say that, the best Bluetooth speaker that I have ever heard or seen, and it's actually an electrostatic speaker, which is a little bit different than the type that you're used to seeing. And we'll take a quick, actually, Bob, how are you? Thanks for coming in. I'm so excited about this. I'm already spilling the beans and telling everybody what this is about. So let's take a close-up of this on camera, too. And, Bob, I'll turn it over to you.
Okay. Well, this is a very unique speaker. One of the things that makes it unique is the electrostatic panels. Now, some of the audiophiles are familiar with electrostatics because
we can actually pick that up if you want. And
they've
show the
they've had Martin Logan speakers, or dreamed of Martin Logan speakers, or been to a store and seen a $14,000 tower speaker,
right,
and it sounds really great. And
right.
One of the unique things about electrostatic technology is that it does vocals very well. It does horns. Instruments like drums and cymbals, anything that's in the higher registers, it does it very clearly, and it sort of spaces it out so you can
right.
hear multiple voices and you can hear the details in each voice. Well, the problem has been is that they're really expensive.
They're very expensive. I have a friend, and this is no lie and there's no exaggeration here, who has an electrostatic speaker system built into his walls. Literally into his walls, and both speakers are, well, the electrostatic speakers are, I think, 12 feet by 12 feet on each side. You don't even know they're speakers. I mean, this was custom done, and the cost was well over $100,000.
Yep. Yep.
Well over 10 years ago.
Yeah, and there's lots of stories like this. I'll
and
talk
boy,
to
does
musicians.
It sound good.
And we'll hear the same thing. You know, the
yeah.
number might be $250,000,
yeah.
or,
yeah.
you know, if you go at the low end, it might be $20,000.
If you're lucky.
And the other thing is they're big, and they require you to, at least the ones at Magnolia Hi-Fi, you have to plug in the speakers themselves, because the way that these are built, there's just a thin piece of film that's in
right here. If we go to the webpage, Mike, for a second, I actually have a diagram of what the guts of this electrostatic panel looks like, and there you can actually see it.
So what you have in the middle is a special type of a mylar plastic. There's some chemical compounds in there, but when the guy explained it to me, he just like, think of a heavy-duty trash bag. That's about right, that thickness. And it's coated with chemicals, and then on each side you can see the grid, there is a metal, and it works sort of like a balloon. When you rub a balloon against you and it sticks to it, that static electricity pulls the balloon to you. Well, we do the same thing with the grids.
Right, so you can see the panels there, you can see those grid panels there, and that's essentially what you're describing.
And that's how we vibrate that material. So for 2 years, BenQ, who most people know.
Okay, Mike, you can go back. I'm sorry. There you go.
Most people know for projectors or monitors, but in Taiwan, for example, we have one of the leading contact lenses out there. It lets more oxygen through,
okay.
and so we have this materials group that got on this project, and they said, how can we make an electrostatic speaker be more efficient, be less power, and all those types of things to overcome what your friend had to go through to be able to get amazing sound. So after 2 years, we had developed this part of the speaker, the panel, where in these two panels, we can get about 90 decibels.
And that's about a quarter inch thick, just for your reference point.
So in my hand, you can see it's about the size of my hand. So, and these panels fold in, and that makes it very easy to portable, put in your backpack, or I just put it down like this. Well, in Taiwan, they loved classical music, and a lot of electrostatic music enthusiasts love jazz. They love the stringed instruments, and of course, the first time I saw this, they said, this is tremendous, listen
it
to
is.
Mozart. And I'm like, yeah, you're great. Well, our stringed instruments say Gibson and Fender on the top.
Yeah, for sure.
So the next part of this was the lower end, because one of the dynamics when you have a panel like this, you can get great vocals. You can get zildjian cymbals that sound exactly like a zildjian cymbal. But it's sort of hard to reach down into the lower, 50 hertz range.
Right.
And so what we've done is we've basically went and bought some very expensive, smaller neo-something. There's a chemical name behind it.
Okay.
High-end magnets. Put them back here. And then on the side, there's radiators on the side. So basically when the sound comes in, it goes into what you might see in a studio monitor. So the sound comes in, and there's a DSP that looks at the sound and says, okay, what frequency are you at? And if the crossover from where you go from the lows to the highs is actually well below the vocal range. So an artist can sing and go through their entire, in case of Ariana, four octaves.
Right.
Without hearing any up and downs or anything like that. So the low crossover point basically then separates the bass, and it goes into a separate amplifier, which is tuned, just like a studio monitor. And we had an expert from America who's an anonymous famous guy.
Right.
Fly over, and we tuned it. Then we tuned the vocals. And we basically decided that for this speaker to sound really unique, we wanted this to be sort of like the Simon Cowell speaker where it's the voice, right? We want the voices to
sure.
be the star. A lot of Bluetooth speakers you buy today, they focus on the bass, which is fine.
Right.
And there are a lot of them out there, and they're great sounding speakers. But the problem with bass is that it tends to overrun the
artist. Right, and that's all you hear, and you don't get the appreciation for the other frequencies and the voice frequency that you really, to get the full feel of everything, you want to listen to the full frequency spectrum, which is from 15 kilohertz to 20,000 kilohertz. That's frequently what the human ear can hear. Now, of course, as you get older, that drops off considerably, but anybody who says they can hear, 25,000 and 30,000 kilohertz, it's not going to happen. Now, what's unique about the system to me, I saw this at CES, and I immediately fell in love with the ergonomics of the system, the design of it, just the simplicity of it just caught my eye. It's very, very stylish. And with folding back the panels, it's very portable. It's not heavy at all. You've got function buttons at the top. I'll let Bob tell you about that. But the thing is that if you think about traditional speakers today, they're made of cardboard cones. And no matter what kind of speaker you have, there's some type of cardboard or facsimile thereof, whatever you're going to call it, that actually vibrates back and forth and actually creates the sound. It's that vibration of that cardboard, if you will, on a magnet that gives you, creates the sound going forward and backward and vibrating at a particular frequency. This is electronic. It's electrostatic. And consequently, the sound is much cleaner, much better frequency response, and your ear can actually hear that in the clarity and in the definition of the various frequencies that it's reproducing, unlike the cardboard speakers. So that the fact that you've tuned this electronically plus use the electrostatic technology really makes a device that I don't think there's anything else like it on the market. I haven't seen anything, and the fact that it's portable is just a giant plus, and it's a two-way, it's a speakerphone.
It's a speakerphone.
Okay, so I'm going to give this back to you. If you want to turn it on, I have a power cord here. The Gadget Professor's been playing with this a lot, so we kind of drained the power a little bit, but maybe we should turn it on and let the audience hear. Now, I might also tell you that the positioning of this will also change the sound so that, correct me if I'm wrong, you get sound coming out of the back panels as well.
Yes. So sound on an electrostatic speaker comes both ways. It comes from the front, okay, where you would normally expect a speaker to be heard.
Right.
And it also comes, here, I'm just going to make sure I'm synced in my Bluetooth here.
Okay.
It also comes out of the back. And the thing that is really cool about when you have it under the back, if you put this in a corner,
right,
it sounds sort of like if you were playing the guitar in a corner, you would get sound coming out of the front hole.
Right, because you're getting the pop back from the corner of the wall. It's actually reproducing the sound and throwing it back out at you.
Exactly.
We get sound from the side panels also here?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so that would be here and here, and it's obviously stereo.
And so you get the left and the right, and there we go, showed up. And so when you're broadcasting Bluetooth, it's aptX. So if you have an Android device, you get the aptX is on most of the
right.
Android, and it'll also work perfectly with your phone on my iPhone. So
okay.
One of the nice things of electrostatics that I discovered after playing with this is that, for example, Apple has a classical music for studying internet radio station, and I love it.
Right.
But I can listen to it at very low volume because I don't want to bother anybody. Even though I've got an office,
that's
still don't want
to. That's the advantage of this technology. It can be very soft and you still get the full frequency spectrum.
Exactly. So I'm hearing all of the Mozart and the violins and the interplay, and I'm
right.
It's starting to be a little distracting because I'm starting to listen to the music.
Relaxing
rather than
and enjoying
ignoring it.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then when the phone rings, the music pauses. And then my phone picks up, and it works just like my...
Now, the volume control is always, as usual, would be controlled from the Bluetooth device. You also can lower it or decrease the volume with the buttons that are on the top there. Actually, we can get a close-up probably on camera two of that. Let's see here.
And I'm just getting a call right now, so... Okay. But
Mike, you got a close-up of camera two on there? Yeah,
there
you can see the buttons right there.
So yeah, the buttons down here are for the phone on the top. There you go. This is the pick up and hang up button. So I'll use that a lot when I'm getting a phone call. And then the bottom buttons are the volume button. Now if you're listening to music, there is a kind of a cool mode that we put into the speaker because we have a lot of DSP horsepower in this and we're separating the sound and doing a lot of the tunings. The chipsets and all the functions give us a little bit of flexibility. So what we did with our anonymous high-end audiophile guy is his comment was, I hate all these other modes. I only listen to a speaker on the first mode.
Right.
And I never listen to it in any other mode. So I'm like, well, let's try to do something different since we've got an electrostatic speaker and we're not just trying to make something to sound like something. So what we did is we have the pure mode, which is the way it's tuned to be flat. We have a warm mode, which sounds more like a traditional Bluetooth speaker, a cardboard one that you like. So if you like that kind of sound.
I'd say I like the cardboard.
And and some of them sound really good, right?
Right.
So it's a little warmer. If you have some older rock tunes, for example, that were mastered in analog and then just came over, they actually sound really nice in warm mode.
Right.
And then is if you're like a Lynyrd Skynyrd fan or a vocal type person, a lot of times you want to hear the lead guitar move forward. Or a lot of times you want to hear the voice, like
right.
Leanne Rimes when she does Amazing Grace, okay? You want that voice all the way forward. So we have a vivid mode that where we just did very subtle tweaks, but because of the detail that you were explaining in the electrostatic speaker, what it does is it's like on a mixing board, I just move the vocal line.
That's
up
the beauty of
decibels.
The science that you have, because you're using electrostatic speakers and you're not dealing with a piece of cardboard that really can't do the fine finessing that you can do electronically with the electrostatic speakers. That's the big difference, essentially, is the fine tuning, the electronic fine tuning that just, quite frankly, can't be done with a cardboard speaker. It just can't be done. But because of the electrostatic technology, you're able to make those fine tune adjustments. Now, where would that button be?
So the mode button is actually the same button to hang up.
Okay.
So it's right over here. And then if you want to advance the music when you're playing and just reach over and skip to the next song on your Pandora, you can either pause it or
okay, and we have other mechanisms to bring in sound, I see, on the back. We'll have to put this over here so Mike can, let's unplug this for a second. And Mike can get a good close-up of that.
Okay, so we made some interesting trade-offs on the speaker because we designed it for the audiophile. First of all, when we charge it, we use a regular power adapter, which is this far piece here. So it does, you're not going to charge the battery on a USB.
Right.
The USB is over here. And on a normal speaker, you just use that for charging. But what we did was something a little bit special. Because a lot of us have, say, an iMac. I've got an iMac on my desk. Or you listen to a lot of music on your notebook. Well, what you can do here is you can take your digital audio from your Macintosh or from your notebook or
go right into that,
and you go right into
that.
That
is sweet.
So
that is nice.
It's a 16-bit digital signal going all the way up to 48 hertz, which the speaker probably won't hit that highest one, but it is a phenomenal signal.
Wow.
So I could just drop it right in there. So when I'm
well, of course, that would be a better signal in terms of frequency response and quality than the Bluetooth would.
Yeah.
Because whenever you transmit over Bluetooth, you're losing a lot of stuff. You just are, and that's just inherent in the technology. So if you now take this, this sounds great in the Bluetooth mode, and we'll let you hear that in a minute. But if you come right out of the computer or your smartphone directly into that, that even accentuates the sound even to a better level.
So when we were doing some testing, there's a lot of FLAC music and a lot of high-res
right.
music.
That's a file, FLAC, FLAC.
And so at CES, we had a Sony player with a FLAC, but we were testing it on our PC player
right.
using a digital audio, and it was really amazing. It was just because there's even more signal that these things can reproduce. You can hear more breathing, and the artist, in Norah Jones, for example, she's got a high-definition version of the
right.
of some of her songs. And you can hear
And you can hear that the difference between a basic MP3 and a FLAC, because there's more frequency response, more fidelity in the FLAC file than there would be. But you would be surprised how much you don't hear because the quality of the file's not that good. And if you have a FLAC file and you have a cardboard speaker, it may sound slightly better, but this really, this electrostatic technology really brings the true essence of the sound out. So, all right, everybody's waiting to hear this. So do you want to replug it in? I've been pounding on it, so I sucked out all the battery. Now, by the way, speaking of battery, 12 hours.
12 hours. So I have a 12-hour battery, and the battery is, the whole thing weighs only a couple of pounds. So what we're going to do here, play one of the test songs we used when we tuned it.
This is Steely Dan, by the way, one of the Gadget Professor's favorite bands.
It's a little more complex here where you can start hearing more instruments.
Up on the hill, people never stand. They just
I can feel the bass as I'm holding this in my thumb.
You can also hear the bass in the lower end.
The bass is excellent, as far as I'm concerned. It's there, but it's not banging you, and I can listen to the other sound clearly.
Right. So we decided, since everybody was zigging, we were going to zag. Here's an acoustic song with just acoustic guitar, voice, very simple, but you can hear the clarity.
Feels like my head's inside the guitar.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road.
And in the second here, you're going to hear a nice little harmony.
And although this wave is stringing us along,
believe me, the sound is extraordinary. Again, we're transmitting this through the microphone, through the mixer, back out to you on the internet. But sitting here in the studio, I feel like I'm in the concert.
So let's take a tougher one, an R&B song. And this is one that I showed a reviewer, and she really got excited because you could hear a lot of other details besides the traditional bass that everybody demos this song with.
It is so crystal clear.
You can hear the bass, but it doesn't dominate.
This life can make me so confused.
There's no question that the bass is there. It's more than adequate. But the beauty of this is it's blending all the other frequencies just splendidly. And you're really able to hear the full spectrum of sound.
Now there's one vocal song that everybody likes is Leanne Rimes, where you can just hear her voice. So from a technical
it's
standpoint,
it's like you can hear a pin drop with this. It's just astonishing to me.
You can hear the way she attacks the notes, holds the notes, manages her breathing.
Oh, absolutely. I was just going to say the breathing, you know. I got to tell you, if you've watched The Gadget Professor for a while, and I've been doing this for over 3 years, you know that, no lie, I've probably reviewed 50, 60 Bluetooth speakers, and some of them have been just extraordinary. I have to tell you. There's no connection between the two of us. I just happened to meet you by chance at CES, and I heard that. And at CES, it was very, very noisy, and I could barely hear Bob, never mind the speaker. But when he turned it on, instantaneously I recognized and appreciated the clarity of sound and the full frequency spectrum that this actually reproduces. And it's quite frankly because of the engineering of the electrostatic speaker, the technology, plus all the fine tuning that you've done electronically, and the speakers themselves are able to take advantage of that. But this particular speaker, in my opinion, is just the best I've ever heard in terms of full frequency response, a pleasing sound, really hearing the detail in the sound, not being overdriven by hard pumping bass, but yet the bass is still there. It's full, it's rich sound, and I'm really amazed by the whole product that you have. I think it's outstanding, and I give it 5 stars from the Gadget Professor, and that's about as high as you can get, and I think it's the highest rating I've ever given a speaker. I really like it, and I've listened to it a lot, and I've listened to various different types of music on it, and it's just fantastic. I can't say enough about it. So let's get down to the nitty-gritty. Is it available, first of all?
Yes, it just went on shipping this week. We are putting out a press release this week, and it's available on the BenQ store, which is... because they're hard to make at the beginning.
Right, I'm sure.
So we don't have, thousands of them, but we do have them in stock, and they sell for $2.99 in the store. And,
okay.
There's a promotion where you get free overnight shipping.
Okay, so we're going to offer our fans free overnight shipping, and we'll actually have a link on the show notes. And again, if you want to get the show notes, just go to our webpage, www.thegadgetprofessor.com. Subscribe to the show notes, and I believe that we will have the we just found this out like literally 10 minutes before Bob came online here, walked into the studio, that we're able to use a code, and Mike will be able to put that code, I believe, right underneath us now. So that code you're seeing, if you go to that URL, that will give you the speaker for $300, which I think is given that it's a portable speaker and it's electrostatic, people might be thinking that's high, but when you hear it, if you appreciate good sound, clean sound, and the full frequency spectrum being reproduced accurately, you're gonna love this thing, and you're gonna want two or three of them. I just can't say enough about it. I'm that impressed with it. And if you've been watching me for a long time, I don't get overly excited about much, but this speaker really is superb, and I really, really like it. And Bob, I can't thank you enough for flying in, and we kind of got the scoop on this one, folks, because believe me, this is the first time you're seeing it. It's only the second time I saw it. When I saw it at CES, they weren't available. You were kind of hemming and hawing, like, when are they available? Like,
We shipped out our first product on 48 hours before, so that was
really
our first customer.
Wow.
So the timing of this is perfect, and we're really excited to be here and to hear somebody that has seen a lot of speakers.
I've seen my share of them.
You know, BenQ's not known as an audio brand.
No, that's what was surprising to me, because typically you're known for your monitors and you do a lot with projectors and things of that nature.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have a lot of people in our company, like many companies, that are passionate about music. My boss is a hardcore audiophile.
Oh, is that right?
Oh yeah, and he can hear things that I can't.
Henceforth.
And but as we develop this, we realize that every audiophile wants one of these things. They just don't have $10,000 to put in their wall or whatever the figure was. So we've actually gotten a lot of passion around this, and it's grown in momentum and enthusiasm.
You can hear and feel the passion in the product. The other thing is, this is so good that I think we're going to probably want to use one or two of these in the back studio for a studio monitor. So if you're out there doing production work, I would just take a listen to these things. And you know what? I would be surprised if you didn't purchase one, because the sound is that good. And when you're back in the studio where Mike is running all the controls, you really need that high-quality sound. And also, what you mentioned before is quite true. If you lower the typical speaker, it gets to the point where you kind of hear it and you kind of don't, because the clarity gets muffed up because you're lowering the sound, and that cardboard really can't vibrate as much as it would like to because of the texturing of it. But that's completely eliminated with the electrostatic technology. Henceforth, when you lower it, you're still maintaining that full frequency spectrum and the volume at the same time, so you're able to enjoy it at a softer level, which is quite nice. So, you know, when you're in the back there doing the studio work, this makes a great studio monitor, and it's got a kick to it. I cannot turn it up all the way because I don't want to blow out this $500 microphone, but it rocks, trust me. So, Bob, thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
I enjoyed it, and fans, I'm telling you, if you're in the market for a Bluetooth speaker, just hold up and take a look at this this BenQ TreVolo. Is that how we're pronouncing it?
TreVolo,
okay. Mm-hmm. And
the Italian flair.
TreVolo. And there is a website that you can go to. I'll have this in the show notes that will tell you all about the speaker and the functionality of it. And I can't say enough about it. I'm quite impressed. So that's going to wrap it up today for the Gadget Professor. I hope you enjoyed this astonishing technology. I'll see everybody next week. So long from the Gadget Professor.
The Gadget Professor is produced by Don Baine,
Multimedia Communications, LLC.
If you would like your product reviewed on The Gadget Professor or would like to appear on The Gadget Professor, contact us via email at thegadgetprofessor@gmail.com. The opinions expressed on the program by the host, guests, call-in listeners, or chatters are solely the opinions of the original source who expressed them. And thank you for watching The Gadget Professor.